Hello and welcome to LabRite. Continuing with making some armor, I've made some padded gambeson legs, which make a great addition to your gambeson torso armor. And also, if you are going to use some kind of plate on your legs, they make good underlayer, so there's no chafing on your skin and the plate is actually comfortable to wear. So, if this is something that interests you, stay tuned and I'll show you exactly how I made these.
We start by making a template. Now you can find templates online in LARPing forums or in books, but I always found it quite easy to just make my own, and this is just a leg, so not complicated at all. And it's time to add our measurements. That would be from your belt height down to your crotch height, and the length of your leg. And then you need the thickest part of your leg, the circumference, and down at the bottom the skinniest part at your ankle. And add a bit of extra, add a bit like 10 centimeters extra, so it fits really nice and isn't too tight. Now we transfer this template onto some template paper. And I also remeasure and correct my measurements in the process. And then just cut it out with some scissors. After cutting it out, clean up and test if it will actually fit, but this point it's kinda hard to tell. I'm positive it will, so the blanks from my window have to go, they are needed now. I transfer my template using tailor's chalk onto this thin, soft linen. This will make the inner lining for the legs. I found this on eBay. And it has been shielding my workshop from the sun for almost a year. I do a single, simple stitch, closing it up at the side. Just so I can test if this will actually fit. And it does, so it's time to do the rest. This is a wool blanket, an old surplus army blanket I got on eBay, I think. I had this for a few years as well. And once again, transfer and cut out. This is the thickest and heaviest linen I could find on eBay, and this will make the outer layer of the Gumbazon leg. Once again, transfer and cut out. I will start by stitching the outer linen layer to the wool blanket padding, and I just go around the outside once using black synthetic yarn that is really strong. It's almost impossible to tear apart by hand. You would sooner cut into your own flesh. Now I'm marking a cross pattern using the corners of the piece as a reference point, and it's just as wide as this board is I use to mark it down. You don't have to do a cross pattern, it could be a linear pattern as well or punctural, but you have to fix the outer layer to the padding or it won't stay in form right. I'm trimming off the edges so it's all nice and flush, then it's time to sew it together. First with a simple stitch and then a cross stitch so it won't come undone. And I'm stitching through the padding here, but you could also do it like I did in How to Make a Gumbazon, just stitch through the outer layer. Having done that, it's time to get our inner lining in here. And I just secure this at the end. Stitch it together and secure it with a cross stitch. And it still fits very well. I'm using these thin leather strips I pilfered from an old couch, and I will sew them using my leather sewing awl to the edges of the leg just to secure them. And it also looks pretty good, I think. You could also just fold it over twice, like I did in my How to Do a Gumbazon video. That is a quicker and easier way to do it, and you don't need any leather. With my sewing awl, this was a lot of work, about 3 episodes of Deep Space Nine, and I did most of that off camera. Also stitched on these 2 leather loops you use to secure the leg to your belt, and this finishes the build. Hope you liked this video. Thanks and goodbye.